Welcome to Dunn Golfing. If Jack D ever played golf, yeah, that's pretty much what the channel's all about. You might be thinking, what? But yeah, if you're an exponent of Mike Austin, Ben Hogan, Mo Norman, Sam Snead, we are kind of always have been here trying to find that game and get ourselves on the golf course in a way that blends old and new together. Because let's not try and reinvent the wheel. It wasn't broken with the greats. So, yeah. Scotland's out of the Euros. Oh, but I tell you, we went out in a blaze of glory. We did, for once, absolutely play attacking football from the word get-go. Shots on goal, just couldn't score enough. But very exciting for Scottish football. The lads can hold their heads up and walk with pride because they gave it their all. They tried like bears. Right, quick sort of what's in the bag. I'm gonna oh no, this should move, I think. Let's see. There we go. So, bag update. I know a lot of people do what's in the bag updates. We'll do it quickly. Cleveland, 3 wood, tour issue, FT5. It's pretty rare. It's very rare actually. Can't tell you whose it was, but it's actually that neutral with the L, which is low core. If you know what kind of a tour issue club this is, you'll know it's very rare. Still got the trusty Titleist 9110H. That's in the bag. Change, well, slight change. Wilson forged blades, 4-2 pitching wedge. They're classics. They're forged, but they have some help, and they are just lovely. What's that one? 9-iron. I'll take one club because I need to show you the wedges now. We've gone smart, back to old school. 53-degree gap in from the pitching wedge. And my trusty, or that I found in a bargain bucket, the trusty rusty tri-bounce Cobra 59 degree. I know some of you are going to say 59 degree, never heard anything like that, because it's got the tri-sole. You can either open or close the face, and it's very versatile. Also, it's got a very rare 200 spin dynamic gold tour issue shaft on it. It's actually stamped out the tour van, but probably the camera won't pick it up. You can see some mad, there you go, mad stamping from the tour van. It's all there, and the grooves are fine. These things rust, as does the Cleveland. It rusts as well. So that's the bag. Hopefully I can cut this and we'll join you and show you what major changes we are working on and having great success with. I love it because all you guys are going to be cracking up saying it's in the wrong ratio and it's not for YouTube. And if I hear that one more time, I'm just going to keep putting these videos out in this ratio. Do you know why? Because I'm not a big YouTube channel. I'm not looking for 200,000 subscribers. I only want to get to about 1,000 subscribers so I can get all the money and revenue to charity. As you know, Macmillan Cancer, Help the Heroes, and Shelter UK. So, hey, share, like, and subscribe. Get this rolling to 1,000, right? We'll get the money to the charities. Right, using this club, going to show you something. Once you get this, you will have come to terms with what's holding you back in golf. Mike Austin, Ben Hogan, Mo Norman, they all did this, and it's all to do with a triangle. Addressing the ball in whatever position you want, right hand low in the club. And as you know, we want to get in this position here, bent lead arm at impact. Okay, club fairly low in close to us and moving in this direction. See how that moves that direction, and this moves this way. Okay, but if you work out what the angle is here, from here to here, it obviously moves on line, and then you can fire down the line for a longer period of time, therefore keeping the club more straight. But there's three other things you need to work on, okay? Let me get... just this pencil will do it. Okay, if that pencil is the line, okay, and your club is here. Yeah, we'll do it that way. We'll do it that way, right? Here's the outside of the club. Every divot you take should be on this side of it here. If you take a divot over here, this side, you're in trouble. So say the ball's here, you just want to go this way with the club. Okay, so which means you're keeping the club in and round, in and round. See how rotation squares the face? It's all to do with the angle, the seven. We'll be explaining more of this. I'm playing golf tomorrow at Tilly Allen, so I might film some of that, because really I'm shooting it really low. And it's basically all come about through just getting the club up here and in, and you can see that this whole side goes like this, giving you, you really want this arm, the feeling of this shoulder being as far away from there as possible, which gives you this position here with the hands ahead, and then you can move. And that's the other thing you need to work on. Start, you know, hitting shots and stopping at impact, right? And hitting the shot at impact, like bang, stopped. You want to hit shots square with the face square. You want to hit shots with the face closed, and you want to hit shots with the face open, right? And you want to do this at the driving range in quick repetition. So have five balls, square, 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 right? This is training, hand and eye, face coordination. Nothing fancy, nothing difficult. Draw that line. You want your club to be left of the line, never right of it, right? And then once you've done the square and the ball square, then closed, 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 right? And then open, 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 right? And this is teaching you impact really quick. It'll totally change your game. And, you know, you're not doing anything that tour players don't do. Tour players do this all the time. What this channel is all about is giving you tour stuff that you can use to really fast track your game. And that's really all I've got for this Thursday. It's really good. I can't believe I managed to pick up a trusty rusty again. 59 degree too, just great, because the likes of me, a bit old school, I like to open the face, I like to close the face, I like to, you know, I'm more a shot maker than I just pull a wick. Like, you know how people put four wedges in the bag and they have a set distance for each one? No, I'm like a, well, I'll hit it this hard, or I'll hit it that hard, or I'll do that, or do this to get it that distance, right? It's all feel. I don't go, give me that 50 degree, no, give me that 54, no, give me that 58, no, give me that 48, no, no. Two wedges for me is enough with a normal set wedge. And that's the way I should always have stuck playing, because for a while there I had three wedges in the bag and it was just like feel totally gone out the window, because it was too much set on the GPS says it's 110 yards. Give me the 56. It just doesn't work like that. You need to have feel, and you need to get, like, regardless of the yardage, you need to be swinging and running in the correct shot. A running low wedge, a baby nine iron,
110 yards, it's a 9-iron. It's not a 9-iron, but you know, it is a 9-iron if you play it the way you want to play it. That's how golf should be played. None of this power mad, and belt it up the middle and then try and, oh man, I just can't believe how golf's gone almost full circle. But as I discussed in the last video, just quickly before we go, people said, oh yeah, Tiger Woods started all that with the power. But Tiger Woods used power when he needed it, and he knew when to dial it right back and swing. When he wanted to get out of jail or he was in trouble, he had like extra power that no other player had, and he was able to deliver it. You know, you've all seen the shots where he's curved it or he's gone for this drive and it's like near 100 yards further than normal, you know, that he normally hit it. So he had that go-to power that all these other players, they haven't got that go-to power. If you watch Colin McGregor on the range with Tiger, he actually admits that he can't do what Tiger's doing. Tiger was swinging up and down and matching his body and his torso at every speed. Like full swing, really slow, matching up, hitting this 3-iron 165 yards. That is pure skill. Colin, on the other hand, was like, I've only got the one full out or nothing. I don't have that shot. I can't do that shot. I can't do half shots. I can't do field shots. I'm just full out gun. And that is all that guy has. Doesn't make him any worse at scoring, but it makes him worse when he gets out of position because he's not got that recovery shot. He's only got that one shot he knows. Whereas Tiger has got all this in the bank. And it's all to do with this magical thing here. As you can see, once you get the relationship of this, whoom, and you feel it yourself, and the Ben Hogan bent elbow, everything just makes sense when you get this in here, because you feel where the club is, you're already getting the drop, you're getting the horizontal, and you're getting this in here moving, and this moving here. So you'll find it on the golf course. You just have to go looking for it. Best way to go looking for it is, like I said earlier, with those three drills. Square club face, open club face, closed club face. Start with a wedge, start with 7-iron, and stop at impact till you know where square is, you know where closed is, you know what it feels like, and you know where open is, you know what it feels like. Right, and then you can start slowly gearing up your full swing and feeling where impact is, engaging it. And that's what golf is, feel. So, thanks for watching. Remember, if you can sub, and if you've lasted this long, congratulations. Thanks for watching. I've been Mike, and I am done golfing, if Jack D ever played golf.